it's Meg, welcome back to my channel, and this is day 5 of Junk Journal January. So today's prompt is textured. So this is one of those prompts that was focused more on the materials that you're using. You can obviously interpret it however you'd like, so if you want to use it more for like exploring anything else, but we kind of used it as a way of encouraging you to maybe think outside the box a little and experiment with the types of materials that you're using within your junk journal, whether it's like using something new or you know, something that might not necessarily be like a typical journal supply that adds texture to your page, whether it's adding like paint and mixed media that can add texture, whether you want to add fabric to your page, basically just encouraging you to experiment and have a play around with the types of like junk journal pages that you can create, and as well making the most of like any supplies that you've got around. So even if you're upcycling and recycling different things, you know, if you look at things from how can I use this in my journal, it really does change your perspective quite a lot, especially when you're, you know, you might be like out and about and you see like a nice napkin and you're just like, that would look really nice in my journal, and it would create a lovely texture and it would document where I've been. And I'm speaking from experience, I've done that so many times. I'm always collecting little napkins and leaflets from places, but they're really good like little mementos from your day that you can put in your junk journal. So even if you don't want to write about your day or you know, document it that way, adding little bits and pieces from like along your travels is a great way to incorporate like your life into your junk journal, if that makes sense. You don't necessarily just have to use like generic like scrapbook papers or you know, like ephemera that's already pre-made. You can create your own ephemera from things that are around you already, and that adds like texture and layers to your page. So for this page, I'm focusing on using things that are all different textures. So at the beginning you saw me scrumple up a piece of paper. That's probably one of the easiest ways to add texture to a page, is using like scrumpled up paper, and then if you flatten it back out, then it gives a really nice effect. And when I was folding the page, I was gonna trim it, and then as I folded it over, you might have seen the like pattern from the illustration that was on the back, just gave a really nice border to my page, so I decided to keep that. I just thought that looked really nice. And again, it's like, even if you're adding layers, that's adding texture. You're adding like interest to the page, so I'm just going ahead and collaging different elements onto the page, just experimenting, seeing where I like things, where I like the look of things. I like to not glue things down straight away, so you can get an idea of what your page is going to look like as you're creating, because there's nothing worse than you've glued something down and then you decide to change your mind and your glue's already stuck and then you rip everything. So I would definitely suggest you know, trialing out where you're going to stick things before you stick them down, otherwise you might end up in a bit of bother. But so yeah, I'm just literally grabbing all different types of papers. So what have I put in? I've put in, so that I had that old book paper, I've added tracing paper, I've added some brown card. I'm going in here with some more like brown paper. It's more of a thin brown paper that you'd get in like packaging, so it has that kind of like rustic texture, I would say. And as well with like a lot of brown paper, it's quite thin, so it won't add a lot of bulk to your page, but if you do like crumple it up a bit, it just really adds a lovely like texture to your page. And if texture's today's prompt, that's what we're going for. So yeah, just have a play around with what you've got. I'd love to know what you've used to create texture in your page, or like maybe leave some suggestions of what you think would make good texture. Whether it's collaging and papers, or whether it is like paint and like mixed media kind of things. I know we always used to do in art class, like there'd be projects where it would be like we had to go and find things and then paint a piece of paper and then like draw into the paint and see what kind of textures we could create. So I remember using like twigs and forks and like sponges and like rocks off the beach, things like that, just to create different patterns and interest and textures on our pages. You could even create your own ephemera by doing like a large piece of paper painted and then creating these textures and then you know, ripping that up and making like tags or collaging with that. The possibilities are endless. So yeah, really have a play around with what types of things you can include. As you can see there, I've also included a like what would you call it, like a dried flower, a gypsophilia, I believe it's called, baby's breath, that's the one. I couldn't think what I was thinking of then. And I've included that as a bit of like texture. And when I did finish the page, I did actually take it off because I just didn't like how it looked. But adding like flowers or like, well, dried flowers or leaves or, you know, things that you might find in nature, that's also a way to add texture to your journal pages, especially if you like nature and including nature in your art, and maybe you're more drawn to that, then being able to, I don't know, if you're going on a hike or you're just like having a walk in the countryside or along the beach, whatever you've got access to, you know, whether you document it by picking up a leaf or a flower or whatever it might be that you find, I don't know, a bit of driftwood maybe. It would obviously have to be quite thin and small, but you know, even stuff like that, whether you include it on a page or whether you use it to create something that has texture, then that's another way that you can sort of widen the scope of what you use in your journal, because well, as with all journaling and all art journaling, but especially junk journaling, I seem to find that a lot more goes. I don't know, it just seems a lot more like of a rugged style of art journaling. I think that's probably why I like it, because there's a lot less pressure on what you're creating and the types of things you're using, and like, you know, you don't have to look it doesn't have to look perfect. There's no right way to junk journal. You can junk journal with vintage supplies, you can junk journal with like how MiaVibes always says, with like real junk journaling, like you know, literal junk from your life. You can create full-blown rainbow junk journal if you love bright colors, but if you're anything like me, then you like the more muted style and that sort of vintage look, which is quite popular. But I just think it's a great way to like, I like it for upcycling and recycling old books, giving new life, and then also just being able to be creative as well. I just think it's a really great outlet for that. So I'm just adding, basically I just added anything to this page, because I'm going in now with some washi, and I was also drawing like some leaves, and as you can see, I also covered up that green plant washi that I originally used to attach the page. I just thought it was a bit too bright and garish for the page. I really like that washi, but I think that definitely suits itself to a more clean, crisp like page, and this page just wasn't the one, so I covered it up with some brown grid washi tape, and then I've also used some cutouts from the printable that MiaVibes and I created for the challenge as well, and then basically I'm just sort of collaging anything that I could find that was laying around. So this is a floral like rose washi tape, and I just cut around it because it's one of them ones where it's like a sort of a bit translucent, so if you like push it down properly, it kind of like blends into your page. I really love those washies, so I just cut around the design just to minimize the like the lines around it and to make it blend in more. And then here I'm just adding some more washi and some more white lines to the page, and just sort of fiddling at this point, deciding whether I want to add more to the page. This was quite a busy page that I created now that I'm looking back at it. I was really going for it with all the elements that I was adding to it, like squeezing in that washi tape there in the bottom left hand corner, but I was just really having fun. So I do get asked by some people like how I know when a page is finished, and like how do you know what your page is gonna look like. So I just think that like you just sort of get like a bit of a feeling when something's finished. You know, sometimes I'll look at a page and there'll be some space, but I'll think like, no, that's enough for what I wanted this page to be. And then other times I'll look at it and I'll be like, there's a bald spot, we need to put something there. And then I will go and see what I can put there. But if you get to a page, if you get to a stage on your page, that was hard to say. If you get to a stage on your page and you don't know whether you want to add something else, I would say step away and come back to it with fresh eyes, maybe another day or in a week. And then normally you'll be able to tell, oh right, that's what was missing, or no, I actually really like it this way. Or you could even go ahead and photocopy your journal page, then experiment with what you were going to do on the photocopy without the pressure of ruining the real thing. And then you might decide that you do like that, and then you might decide you don't like it, and you were really glad you did it on the photocopied version and not the real version. So there's a little tip for you if you want to experiment with what might go on your page. So I really hope you've enjoyed another junk journal with me. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss these junk journal with me's that I'm doing for the Junk Journal January Challenge. I will leave links down below for everything that you need to know about the Junk Journal January Challenge. Go look in the hashtag, go show everyone some love with all the beautiful pages that are being created. It's so amazing, the little community that we've got going for the month. So yeah, I hope you have a wonderful rest of the day or evening, wherever you are, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!